Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today we want to talk about a few verses in the Catholic Epistle. The Catholic Epistle was from San, do you remember? From where? From San John. From first Epistle of San John, chapter 4. It says, whoever confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. We call ourselves Christians, and we believe and confess that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Correct? But to be honest, this is not enough. What does it mean? This is not enough to inherit the kingdom of heaven. This is not enough. Your confession and your belief that Jesus Christ is the Son of God is not enough. Because basically, the devils have the same belief. They believe also that Jesus is the Son of God. And they confessed that, yes, they did. In the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 4, it says, and the devils came out of many, crying out and saying, you are the Christ, the Son of God. It's the same. This is our confession. This is our faith. This is our belief. So to confess only, it's not enough to inherit the kingdom of God. Because the devil have the same faith and they have the same confession. So I think we need to do something to confirm that belief or to prove that. So let's continue reading in the Epistle of St. John. He said, we have known and believed the love that God has for us. So God is love, and he who abides in love abides in God and God in him. So the first, he talked about the confession, to confess, to believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And to confirm that belief, you have to love. This is the difference between us and the devil. The devil confessed, but they hate us. They hate everyone. They want to take our portion in the kingdom of heaven. They want to take us away from God. Because they don't love. They don't love God. They don't love us. But the difference between us and the devil is the love. Love is the magical word in our Christianity. Love is the key of heaven. Love will determine if we go to the heaven or not. It's very important. So, but before I talk about the love, I noticed something in this verse. He said, we know and believe the love that God has for us. Let's read it one more time. We know and believe the love that God has for us. This verse makes our Lord Jesus Christ is a perfect role model for us in everything. So why? Why is he a perfect role model? Because actually, he did what he said. He set a law of foundation in our Christianity. He established the foundation of Christianity, but before he established and he ordered us to do whatever we do, he did all these things. For example, he said, you have to love, but he loved us. You have to fast, he fasted before us. Have to pray, he prayed. You have to take communion, he took communion. For that reason, he said, we know and believe the love that God has for us. We know and believe. So let's see how God loved us. Because this is the topic of this sermon, a love. First, Jesus loved us before he created us. Can you imagine? He loved us before he created us. And I can say the love was the main reason that God created us. God created us to share him the love. God created us to share the love with him, not to worship him. Can you imagine? How come? Because actually, if God created us to worship him, it means like he has something. He has a defect. Because he created like a weak nature, like the human beings from the dust, to worship him. Doesn't make any sense. Because actually, the angels and the heavenly hosts, they are worshiping God before us. So why did he create us? He created us to share the love with him. And we can see that very clearly in the Gregorian liturgy. Saint Gregory said, "You have no need of my servitude, but rather I had need to your lordship." So this is the main reason of creature, just to share the love with God. But we worship God because we love him. It's a sign of love. Because we are very grateful to him. We loved him, so we worshiped him. Because he deserved that. So this is the first point. So the second sign of love of God to us. The Bible said, he made himself of no reputation, taking the form of bondservant. He came to the earth. And he left all the glory and the heaven and the praises, everything for us. And can you imagine when a king or like a president decided to live as a regular person and to leave all the glory and greatness which he had and to be a regular person? But Jesus, to be honest, was not a regular. He was a servant. He came to serve us. Jesus, the King of the Kings, who is sitting upon the throne of his glory, he decided to be a servant. Why? To save us. Why you have to do that? Because I love you guys. Because of the love, because of his love, he isolated himself. He left all the glory and the greatness and came as a servant to save us and to return us back to the paradise of joy. So, this is good about the love. But the other things regarding the love, why did he do that? Why did he leave the heaven and came to be a man? It's a long story. And all of us know it, but we need to remember ourselves with it every time. Jesus wants to restore us to the original image of God. Because God, when he created the human beings, he created the human beings on the image of God. So when Adam committed the sin in the paradise of joy, the whole human nature become corrupted. So who can fix this corruption? He's the only one without sin, Jesus Christ. So it was the only way to fix that corruption, to came to the earth and talk flesh and be a man and live with us and save us. All these because of his love. To abolish the sentence of death which reign over us, to set us free from the bondage of the sin, from the bondage of the death. And why he are doing that? Because he loved us. Can you imagine? We committed the sin against God, and we left him, and we told him, now we are sick, we are corrupted, we are bad, we are not deserved. But because he is merciful and loving, he came to us to save us and to set us free. And finally, he completed his love by paying all our dues. He died for us and gave us the freedom and returned us back to paradise of joy. So, today when Jesus commanded us to love each other, he did it perfectly before. He didn't ask us for something impossible. Because he did it when he was a human being. And also, when the Bible tried to describe God, he described it with love. God is love. He's the main source of love. So today my question, to love God, what shall I do? So the first thing he mentioned here in the Catholic epistles, I will read one verse. If someone says, I love God and hates his brother, he is a liar. For he who does not love his brother whom he see How can he love God whom has not seen? So this is the first thing. You cannot say, I love God and you hate your brother. You are a liar. You are a liar. You're not telling the truth. And there is no space for the liars in the kingdom of heaven, in the paradise of joy. There is no space for you if you are telling lies. If you cannot love, if you hate someone, can you imagine to go to the heaven and you hate the sins behind, like around you? Who's gonna allow you to go there? What will you do there? If you hate your brother, how can you meet with him in a paradise of joy? How can you do that? This is impossible. This is true and very practical. If you couldn't love each other, we cannot love God. The other thing, because we are the image of God. Every time you hate your brother, you hate God because you hate the image of God in your brother. So to make it easy, to love your brother, imagine that you are dealing with God himself. So can you give God an attitude? Of course not. If Jesus is between us, can we give him an attitude? Of course we can't. Can you be impatient with him? Of course we can. So did the same thing with your brother. Because this is the image of God which you can see. And without loving of your brother, you have no portion in the paradise of joy. This is an important scale to measure your love of God, how much you love your brothers. So do we have any other scales determine that how much we love God? Of course, there's a lot. So the first one we said, you have to love your brother. The second one, it's in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 14, verse 15. It says, if you love me, Jesus is talking to the disciples, if you love me, keep my commandments. If you love me, keep my commandments. Some people keep the commandments, but because they are afraid from the punishment. They are afraid from God, so they keep the commandments. But we call it, this is like the old level of love, like the ordinary level of love. I keep the commandment, I keep the rule because I fear. I'm afraid of. I stay with the traffic rules because I may have a ticket. This is fear. But this is not in our Christianity. This is the old level. This is the for the beginners. But for the A level, for the advanced level, we keep the commandment as much as we love God. And as much as you love him, you will keep the commandment and you will increase. And you will do more. Kid, this is your scale, the scale of love. As much as you love God, as much as you will be honest to keep the commandment, and the God will reward you more. It's a good thing about the honest, to be honest in the commandment. This is an important topic. So today I will finish with a short story about one of the martyrs of the Al-Butrusiyya. Those 29 martyrs. One of those martyrs, her name is Insaf Adil. I think you hear the name. Insaf did something very, very good. And it ends by receiving the crown of martyrdom. Al-Butrusiyya was her not original church. She didn't used to go to this church regularly, but she had her own church. And when she go to the church, she found that they already read the Gospels. They finished it. But she decided to leave her church to go there to attend the Gospel. She said, that's okay. They finished the Gospel. No, I can't attend. If you are in her situation, her position, okay, I'll go to Abuna. Abuna, I came late. It's okay. Abuna, I came after the Gospel. But she decided not to do that. She went to a different church because she was honest with herself. She was honest to keep the commandment. She was honest to keep the rites of the church. She said, no, I have to find another church. And she went to the Butrusiyya. And then there, the crown of martyrdom was waiting for her. If she did as usual, said that's okay, Abuna, I came late and she took communion, she will be like a regular person. But because she was honest with herself, she became a martyr. Look how it's important. Her honesty came from her love to God. Because she loved God from her heart. So she decided to be honest and to keep his commandment. We ask from our Lord Jesus Christ to help us to love him as he loved us, and glory be to God now and forever. Amen.